Gone with the Wind is a novel by American writer Margaret Mitchell, first published in 1936. Gone with the Wind was popular with American readers from the outset and was the top American fiction bestseller in 1936 and 1937. As of 2014, a Harris poll found it to be the second favorite book of American readers, just behind the Bible. More than 30 million copies have been printed worldwide. In the spring of 1861, Scarlett O'Hara lives on Tara, a large plantation in Georgia. She only spends her time dealing with her many suitors and her wish to marry Ashley. One day she hears that Ashley is engaged to be married to Melanie Wilkes, his cousin from Atlanta. At a barbecue the next day, held on the grounds of the Wilkes plantation, she opens up to Ashley about her feelings for him, and he tells her he loves her too but that he's marrying Melanie since she resembles him more, whilst Scarlett is so very different than he is. She slaps him for this remark and as he leaves the room, she suddenly notices that the scandalous, but handsome adventurer Rhett Butler witnessed the whole exchange, and he commends her for being unladylike. When the Civil War starts, Charles Hamilton, Melanie's shy brother, proposes to Scarlett. She agrees sadly, mostly to hurt Ashley. When they marry, Charles joins the army, and dies because of the measles, whilst Scarlett finds out that she's pregnant. When she gives birth to her son, Wade, she becomes bored and deflated. She travels to Atlanta to stay with Melanie and Melanie's aunt Pittypat. She likes the big city and starts seeing Rhett much more. He can get under her skin with his crude remarks and his constant mockery of her, but he also tells her to disregard the restrictions imposed on grieving widows. As the war drags on, food and clothing becomes more and more scarce, as Scarlett and Melanie fear for Ashley's well-being. After the bloody Battle of Gettysburg, Ashley is captured and put in jail, and the Yankee army starts to impose itself more and more on the city. Scarlett wants to return to Tara, but she's made a promise to Ashley, to stay with the pregnant Melanie, who could be giving birth any moment now. On the night the Yankees take control of Atlanta and set it alight, Melanie gives birth to her son, Beau. Rhett helps them escape the city, escorting them through the burning streets, but he leaves them outside the city, to join the Confederate Army. Scarlett drives her cart all night and day to reach Tara. Her mother Ellen is dead, and her father, Gerald, has lost his mind. The plantation has been looted by the Yankees, and there's no food or cotton to be found. As she searches for something to eat, she resolves to never go hungry again. She takes on the job of rebuilding Tara, murdering a Yankee thief and putting out a fire set by a Yankee soldier. When the war ends, she hears that Ashley has been freed and is coming home, as more and more soldiers seem to pass her plantation. The one-legged homeless Confederate, Will Benteen, stays to help Scarlett rebuild the plantation. But he brings bad news a little while later, as Jonas Wilkerson, a former employee of the plantation and now government official, has decided to raise the taxes on Tara, with the plan of driving Scarlett out. In panic, Scarlett goes to Atlanta, wanting to seduce Rhett Butler, so he will give her the $300 that she needs for the taxes. Rhett has become a very wealthy man thanks to his blockade running operation and by speculating on food prices. But she finds out he's in a Yankee jail, so won't be able to help her. She visits her sister's beau, Frank Kennedy, and devises a plan. Wanting to save Tara at any expense, she betrays her sister and marries Frank, pays the taxes on Tara, and she throws herself on Frank's business to make it more profitable. After Rhett uses blackmail to get out of prison, he borrows Scarlett money, so she can buy a sawmill, and to the disgruntled Atlanta society, Scarlett is developing into a smart businesswoman. Gerald dies, and she returns to Tara for the funeral, where she convinces Ashley and Melanie to move to Atlanta and accept a share in the lumber business. A little later, she gives birth to Ella Lorena, Frank's child. A poor white man and his black companion attack Scarlett one day. That night, the Ku Klux Klan retaliate, trying to punish this attack on Scarlett, and Frank ends up dying. Rhett proposes marriage to Scarlett and she consents quickly. After a luxurious honeymoon in New Orleans, Scarlett and Rhett get back to Atlanta, where Scarlett constructs an ostentatious mansion, and spends her time socializing with wealthy Yankees. Scarlett becomes pregnant again, having another child, Bonnie Blue Butler. Rhett cherishes her and slowly starts to win back the approval of the important Atlanta citizens, to ensure that Bonnie doesn't turn out to be an outcast like Scarlett. Their marriage begins happy enough, but Rhett becomes more and more bitter and indifferent toward her as time goes on. Scarlett's feelings for Ashley have dwindled to a cozy, warm friendship, but when Ashley's jealous sister, India, sees them embrace, she's quick to spread the rumor that they're having an affair. Melanie takes Scarlett's side and refuses to believe these rumors, which shocks Scarlett. After Bonnie gets killed in a horse riding accident, Rhett nearly loses his mind, and the marriage suffers yet again. Not long after the funeral, Melanie has a miscarriage and gets very sick, and worried, Scarlett goes and see her. Melanie has her promise to take care of Ashley and Beau, and Scarlett realizes that she loves Melanie and that Ashley was ever only a fantasy. She decides that she truly loves Rhett, and after Melanie dies, she rushes to Rhett to tell him about her insight. Rhett, however, says he no longer loves her, and leaves her. Filled with sorrow, and feeling terribly alone, Scarlett goes back to Tara, wanting to build up her strength once again in the arms of her childhood nurse and slave, Mammy, as she thinks of a way to get Rhett back. If you enjoyed this, please like and subscribe.